Iris, and today I'm going to talk to you guys about how I keep my hair healthy and long. And I'm going to go into detail about the products that I use, the steps that I go through, and the things that I do and don't do to continue having healthy hair. So I hope you guys stay tuned and watch the rest of this video. First of all, I'd like to say that growing long, healthy hair is not an extremely difficult process. It doesn't require upscale hair products that you see at salons, and it doesn't necessarily have to do with the vitamin that you take or any sort of strange sacrifice. It pretty much takes a lot of dedication and a lot of patience. It's more like a question of what you do for your hair and what you shouldn't do to your hair rather than the products that you use. The first step is that you always have to make sure that if you process your hair a lot or if you use a lot of hair products that eventually fry your hair, you have to start by trimming the fried part of your hair. So if your hair is actually fried and dry up to here, you will literally have to cut your hair up to here to start the process all over again. The second thing is that you should trim your hair often. But when I say trim, I mean if you already have healthy hair and you don't have very many dry ends, you only need to trim about half an inch. And half an inch is not really very much. I mean, half an inch is maybe about this much from here and up. So just to give you an idea of how much you should trim when you have healthy hair. And when I say often, I mean I usually trim my hair every 4 to 6 weeks, and that's what works for me. But that's only because I don't like to trim my hair that often, because I like to have long hair. And so I wait about every 4 to 6 weeks and then I trim. The other thing that I do is I avoid heat appliances as much as possible. I mean, I wash my hair, and when I wash it, I want to say about 80% of the time I do not use a blow dryer to dry it. Unless I am in a hurry or I absolutely need to use it, then I use it, but I try to use it at a low heat setting. Actually, recently my husband gave me a ionic hair dryer, and it also has tourmaline in it, and so I'm drying my hair at half the time with half the amount of heat, and that has been the best thing that I have been using for the past few weeks. So that's one thing that's really important, is stay away from heat products, stay away from hot rollers, from curling irons, flat irons, crimpers, anything that's going to add heat to your hair. Absolutely, try to stay away from it, if not minimize it as much as possible. Usually I will use a curling iron only on Saturday if I even use it. For the most part, I curl my hair with the curling system that I have in one of my other videos, which is called How to Curl Your Hair the Healthy Way. That's one of the best ways that I use to curl my hair when I absolutely need to curl it. I don't dye my hair. I just stay away from it. I'm totally fine with being a brunette, and I just don't use any chemicals or anything that's going to alter my natural hair, such as perming it or dyeing it lighter. I have in the past dyed it lighter, and it absolutely has dried my hair. I have a lot of hair fallout, and overall my hair just doesn't appear healthy. It appears frizzy, it appears dry, and so my hair is naturally dark. It's naturally this color, and this is the color that I keep throughout the year. Once in a while, I do dye it really dark black, and my hair actually takes on that color really well. It actually looks really healthy when I do dye it black. So, and I've heard that when you dye your hair darker colors, it's much better for your hair because you're not using harsh chemicals. I'm not a professional, so I'm not really sure, but it has worked really well. And if anybody knows and they want to answer that, you know, why is it that my hair is healthier with darker colors rather than lighter, go ahead and answer it in a comment, or you can send me a message, whatever you like. When I go swimming, if I am exposed to chlorine, first thing I do once I get out of swimming and playing in the pool and all that is I run some shampoo through my hair to make sure that I wash all of the chlorine out. Chlorine is really bad for your hair. It really dries out your hair. You get a lot of hair fallout. If I'm gonna jump into a pool, what I do is I put in a little bit of leave-in conditioner just on like the tips of my hair, or I kind of run it really quickly through my hair. Not a lot, because you don't want it to seep out into the pool, but just a little bit, and it just kind of protects my hair from the chlorine. The next one is really important. I really honestly believe that it is the reason why I have long, healthy hair. I honestly, at all costs, avoid extreme diets. I do not stay away from any types of foods except for foods that are high in sugar or high in fat or dried foods. But I eat vegetables, I eat fruits, I eat chicken, fish, I drink a lot of water, and more importantly, throughout the day, I drink at least 2 to 3 cups of green tea, and that's, I drink Bigelow brand green tea. I will drink about 3 or 4 cups throughout the day, spread out throughout the day, and I know that green tea is said to be really good for your hair. I'm recording this after I've already worked on the editing of my video. I forgot to mention a couple of things. One thing is that I do drink a glass of non-fat milk every night right before I go to bed, and I know that that is really good for your hair. The other thing that I do is I walk every single day. I walk for 30 minutes at least and up to an hour with my dog, and I know that walking overall is just really good for you. I've also read that it does help your hair grow. So those are the two things that I forgot to mention in the previous part of my video. So if you notice in the background, it's a different time of day, but it's only about an hour after I had originally recorded. So I'm going to go ahead and conclude this video. Right before I jump into the shower, I will untangle my hair very gently. And then once I'm in the shower, shampooing my hair and conditioning it, and I come out, it's not as tangled. My hair is wet. If I'm fresh out of the shower and I'm going to dry my hair, I am very extremely careful with the way that I handle my hair. When I towel dry my hair, I make sure not to scrub it really harshly. I'm very gentle with it because it seems that when my hair is wet, it's the most delicate. And so if I'm going to use a comb, I make sure to start at the end. Slowly take out knots. I carry a miniature brush in my purse or a little comb, and throughout the day, you know, I will take out little knots and comb it through. I want to say maybe 2-3 times a day I will actually comb it through, and then one more time at night right before I go to bed. I don't wash my hair every day. I usually let it skip one day, sometimes two, depending on if my hair is very dry, then I will let it skip 2 days. When I don't wash it every day and then I finally do wash it, I get a very healthy shine in my hair. The natural oils in my hair are really good for my hair. So what I do is when I haven't washed my hair for a day, I'll just take a brush and just kind of brush the natural oils throughout my hair. And especially reaching down to the end, that's just really good for your hair. And overall, when you spread the oils that way and then you wash it the next day, it just looks really very shiny and healthy. I have to wash my hair every day. If it's summertime and my hair gets really oily, then what I'll do is I will continue to wash it every day, but I usually just put a little bit of shampoo just at the top of my hair and then rinse it out right away and use a lot of conditioner for my hair. And I'll usually use my conditioner from like the ears down. I don't like to put the conditioner in my scalp because then that'll really make my hair oily, especially in the summertime. And I focus a lot on the ends when I have the conditioner in my hand. I'll actually, you know, rub it into my hand and then put it on the ends of my hair this way. And I'll do that throughout my hair just to make sure that my ends are always moisturized.